I generally do not get too much into concept cars, but this one is different. This one promises a leap in transportation, full autonomy, and a huge prospect for reducing wastages by spurring ride sharing. I got some time to check the Tesla Robo-taxi, and I'm presenting my impressions. It's not going to be long, as this car also seems to have reimagined lean movement, cut on all the non-essentials, and gone that step further in Tesla's minimalist design language, with very, very little of a conventional car's features for me to look at. So let's get into it. The upper panel of the dash is very reminiscent of the Cybertruck. The material is exactly the same and also appears similar to the one on the Model X. The dash is simple and consistent all across and keeps things easy for mass production, much like the rest of the car. The dash is long enough to put a decent distance between the sloping windshield and adds to the safety. The robotaxi is proposed with a 21 inches center display. That's 2.5 inches bigger than the one in the Cybertruck. Some indication of the perceived role of software. This is a space to look for, and all the fun of a self-driven car is going to show here. Or at least there's huge opportunity for the same through several applications. The wing doors are expectedly all plastic, and that's an unusual attempt after the Model X for Tesla. Not sure that's a great idea on durability, especially after all the other areas where it seems as a priority. This could also affect the getting in and out for the passengers, which I guess could be important in a cab. It surprises me after all the other considerations for endurance. The cab has a flat floor and the seats are very low. I think these will be very uncomfortable for anybody whose knees are above the hips in a sitting position, particularly for longer distances. I understand that it's not what the designer expects in the context of a cab, but these still seem very low off the ground. The seats are of very basic vegan leather and with very few enhancements and hardly any bolsters. Between the seats are two basic cup holders, an armrest, and some storage which I could not check with the limited access. So, to summarize the cabin of the concept robotaxi, it just has the 21-inch screen, the two seats, the two cup holders, and some likely storage. You heard me right. I'm so sure there could be much more coming. So, exactly the reason there's such little to sample. But there are some observations I'd like to share. The height of the car seems extremely small, and the seating perilously low. Whenever the knees go higher to the hips in the normal sitting, it's uncomfortable on long distances. So it's evident that the designers don't foresee very long trips, at least in this iteration. The seats themselves look plain and with very little to no bolsters. When seating low, the headroom should be fine. In the front, the robotaxi has a light trim running across with multi-module LED headlights placed in two sections adjacent. It has a relatively large hood that slopes down, but at a very low level in line with the low height of the car. The front bumper, the two small quarter panels, and hood, the three in all along with the light strip, make up the front exterior. It's still styled and put together very well, as you see. This is definitely designed for scalability and large production numbers. On the side are the wing doors, as stated, and they open angularly and not like the Falcon wing doors on the Model X. A single panel covers the rest of the body right up to the rear tail lights, and in the rear, a large hatch opens up to reveal a very large storage. This is clearly for the airport transfers and good capacity short distance cargo. The tires are covered in the same material as the body panels, or so it seems. The light trim on the rear is a part of the hatch that extends right from what would be a conventional row 2 to the rear bumper. Beneath the bumper are the two tail lights placed identically to the ones in the Cybertruck. The rear bumper appears of plastic and there is absolutely no sign of a charge port. This could be hidden, arriving in the future, or who knows, Tesla may have some fleet-style charging solution in the making. This is my speculation. This is a concept car and lots will change in the design and through facts that may eventually come to light. So please take everything with a pinch, and I'll try to update more on this channel as and how I learn about this very exciting project. Tesla is miles ahead of the rest and has actually put out a car without a steering. That's when the rest of the competition is still with lane keeping and highway assistance. Stay in touch with me on this channel to progressively learn alongside. There's no doubt that the timelines Tesla has put out are totally outside of reality. Don't think anybody is even thinking about them. I'd also not be tempted to compare this project with the existing FSD, as that's still designed as a driver assistance for the human driver. This can be and will have the potential to be thought about in a completely new way, and I strongly feel that its computing will move out of the car into the cloud or in some kind of a centralized service. If not now, then at some point. Inside of the car, the technology would grow more as a system with safety features and all kinds of customizations for the passengers. More of entertainment and an engagement experience. This is my feeling and we'll need to see with the passing time. If you'd like to see my 467 miles real world road trip to the Joshua Tree National Park in my Tesla, you can check the video linked here or in the description. See you in the next one.